Welcome to Game 7 for the Reading B Rockets. The Rockets manhandled North Middlesex Cowboys last week. This week they face a very tough Acton Boxborough team. Both teams coming in at 5-1. So these ones may see some playoff implications too. Joined today by Andy Fatino up here, my third cameraman in 3 weeks. And I said, you've been on this thing for what, all of 30 seconds?
I got it down pat.
You've broken the Zoom. And you're still better than Brian Van Horn. That's what you say. Hey, two guys I wanted to mention from last week after looking at film. Number 80, Trevor Conroy. Let's get right into the game here. We can zoom this in if we'll come back for the intro as Lucas Fleming gets set to kick off. It's a great boot by Lucas. Skips up. Number 74 has got some wheels there. And he's got all height open there. He gets ripped down by Troy Pollock, number 7, at the very end of the play. So great job by Pollock. He was the last line of defense. But Trevor Conroy got confused with another player. Trevor played great on both sides of the ball, setting the edge, making a bunch of great blocks and some great tackles. Another player, number 71, Pat Dwyer. Pat got a lot of playing time second half, made a lot of tackles. And if by
yes,
tackles mean getting steamrolled by a guy and pulling him on top of you, he did a little bit of that too. But Pat
Whatever
was great.
It takes.
Number 51, big Zach Kenyon, had a huge run at the end. He did not want to be denied. He had one last guy to get through. He almost went to the house. His first and 10 for Acton Boxborough from their own 47. Three in the back, the old wishbone. It's a handoff up the middle. He's got some speed there. Cuts back. He gets cut down by number, 41. Welcome back, Sean Beckenhuis. He was out last week, and he's probably has the most tackles on the team, Beckenhuis. But that's a nice gain on first down.
And he's fit to be tied this week. Wants to make up for that time.
That's right. I also want to mention number 42, Derek Van Horn. I missed a big tackle that he had. So there's our intro, and we're right into it here. Call it second and 5. Right up the middle. He's got a lot of room. Almost missed there, but he gets pulled down. Great run, and then looks like 22, number 7 was Pollock, and then Damari came in to help him, but it's going to be a first down. So a couple of big holes there in the middle. You know, they got a pretty big line there, too. That big defensive line for the Rockets is in there. We welcome back number 33 is Stephen Webb as well. So he's been out for a couple of games, and he's a big athlete on the outside.
They'll be glad to have him back.
First and 10, it's a pitch out. Big number 48. He's got some wheels on the outside. Steven can't catch him, but he gets tripped up. Number 43, Dante Barboza, trips him up. So we'll come back. It'll be second and 5. Okay, here we are. It's second and 5 here. They got a speedy running back out there of 48. Very good early on here. It's a pitch out right. Oh, almost gets met. He gets met immediately right there. I think that's Damari who comes in and closes it. Webb was in there, pushed him wide, and Danny Damari came in and clipped him down for a loss. So great play there. It's a big third down play upcoming. Here we go. All right, hey, third and 7 here, and this is a big play. Although usually this side of the field, you'll see 4 down territory here. Oh, someone jumps, but he gets back. I don't see a flag. Oh, big hole there. Number 42 on his feet, and Troy comes in, wraps him down, but he's going to be close to the first down. He may have it. So they've opened up some big holes this line. They got some big boys on there on that offensive line. And, for the first time all year, you see the big defensive line of Reading maybe being matched here.
Yeah, definitely being tested.
I want to make it easy on you here, Andy. We have him. He's a two-handed operation because our Zoom's not working. Handoff right up the middle. Big hole again. Nice job right there. Close taken the down door. By, let's see, number 22, Damari comes in and closes it again. So great job by Danny there. Short gain, though, so it's going to be second and 8 coming up. Okay, call it second and 8 here. Big old line there. Handoff right behind. Oh, nice job right there. The closer's right behind. They're trying to run behind big number 72. He's going up against my boy, Oki. I don't think he's seen a kid that big all year. There's not too many guys bigger than him out there, but he's trying to run right over him. That was a great job right there by, I think it was 21 who was in there. Keith Richmond came in and closed that one up. So that's a third and call it 6.
I can't even fit Oki in the screen.
Big third down play here. It's a pitch right. He tries to go outside. He gets some room there. Now he's still on his feet, and he's got the first down and more. So nice run right there for another first down. And Acton Boxborough is moving the ball very well in this first series. Just a steady dose of the run. And just challenging Reading to meet them. Big offensive line, too. So this one looks to be a battle early on, Andy.
Certainly does.
So it's going to be first and goal. I won't say first and goal. Probably first and 10 from about the 14-yard line.
Yep.
Here we are, first and 10 here. Not a big guy at quarterback, number 11. They got some big running backs, some big offensive linemen, too. It's a handoff up the middle. Oh. He cuts back. There's a huge hole there. In comes Dante and Troy to take him down. Almost stripped from behind. You see him come across there, and that would have been nice to put the ball on the ground, but he cut back into a huge hole. You or I could have run through that one, huh?
Seriously.
It was a nice play, though, because it was actually a broken play where he wanted to go, and he took up right, and there was a little bit of over pursuit, so it's going to be second and five coming. Second and five upcoming here. Stacked heavy right here. 42, he cuts left and right. A little shifty backs there. They got some good runners, and he's going to be close, probably just short of the first down, but it's going to be third and two coming up, and we're clearly in fourth down territory here. So four down territory inside the 10. So listen, it's going to be something here for the Rockets to potentially make a stop here because they haven't had success early on. Here we go. It's going to be third and short here. Let's see if these Rockets can get a push here on these guys. You see Lucas Fleming, 24, shifting. He's got to keep it himself, number 11. He gets closed on immediately. So very close. He does stop him short, I think. It was number 21 was Richmond there. I think Jeremy Ross, number 11, came in too. So it's going to be fourth down here. And this is a huge play early on.
It's a very big play. Got to stop him here.
If they stop here, it would be a huge, huge victory for Reading, who's had a very tough time holding these guys. They've marched right down the field in the first series. So huge play here. All right, big, huge fourth down and three here. They're going to go for it. I think number 75 is a lead blocker here. They got some big boys on this B team here.
That they do.
It's a handoff to number 42, and he cuts up, and he looks like he's got the, oh, he's got the friend Moore. He goes in for the touchdown. So forget the first down. He goes in for the touchdown. So nice run by number 42 there. He had a couple of them, and he's the little guy with some shifty moves, and they got some big guys, number 48, who can run too. So on the first series here, Acton Boxborough marches right down against Reading, and early on it's going to be 6-0, and it looks like they are going to go for the kick too. So at this level, the kick's worth two, so these are huge plays right here. There's the kick, and he's up, and it is looks like it's pulled left. So it's pulled left, so fortunate for the Rockets there, but to get away with two less points. But early on in the first quarter, we don't have the time going here, but it's Acton Boxborough 6, Reading 0. All right, Acton Boxborough set the kick here. We're commenting off field here. That goes over to Barboza. Takes it from about the 25, cuts back. Dante's still on his feet. Oh, he's still on his feet, and he gets wrapped up around after about a five-yard gain. And so Reading's going to take over the first series. We're commenting off camera here, Andy. I don't know if I've seen a team this big across the board for Acton Boxborough. They get some big boys at this B level. I said my boy Oki is going up against this kid, 72. He's the only kid I think he's seen bigger than him this year, and there's about five of them on this line who are equally sized.
Yeah, they get some animals out here.
80, 84 big, huge guys on the line. And let's see what the Rockets have in store in their first series here offensively. Lucas Fleming will be coming in at quarterback. First set here, great to have Sean Beckenhuis back, number 41. It's a keeper for Lucas, right? He follows Sean. Lucas drives forward. He's still on his feet, but he gets at least five right there. So that's going to be a nice start on first down. And call it second and four upcoming. All right, here we are. It's second and call it four here after the run by Fleming. And it looks like we have Dan Damari in right on the second play. And he's going to follow Beckenhuis there. Nice cutback by Danny, and he dives forward. He's very close to the first down. He may have it, too, and I think he does. They're already signaling that. So nice cutback by Danny. He's shifty. And they roll back Fleming and Damari back-to-back here for a first down, and Fleming comes right back in. All right, end of the first quarter there already, and the Rockets are going to take over here after the first down by Damari. Right back to Fleming here. Look for him to fall back, and he summons way off there. Number 75, I think that's going to be against Acton Boxborough. So let's duke off another five.
Good thing he was offsides because he was coming in fast and fierce, and he's one of those big boys.
I don't think Dante Barboza was ready for that. Of course, you're not ready for it when he jumps the line. He took a little pop there, number 43, Dante. So we're going to make this one first and five coming up close to midfield. Here we go, first and five here. Troy Pollock in a quarterback for the first time. It's high kick. It's inside thing to Dante. Dante cuts up. He gets pulled down. He drives it forward for just a couple of yards, but just over midfield here. So let's say Dante for three. It's going to be second and three upcoming. Second and short right now. Oh, it's a high snap. It goes over Damari's head, and he just pounces on it. So tough snap right there. It's going to push the Rockets back to a third and long, and Danny does the right thing by hopping on it. But Coach Junta swaps out the entire offense right there. And unfortunate snap for Reading. They had a little bit of momentum going there just for another first down. Now it's going to be a tough one here with third and long. All right, here we go. Patrick Harrigan in there for the first time, third and long. You may see these guys throw the ball. Look for number 11, Jeremy Rosh, down near on the near side here. Steven Webb split right too. So it's going to be thrown out to Webb. He picks it up. Steven makes a nice job there, but they did a nice job tackling. It's a little bit of a low throw, which Steven had to go down for. Maybe if he hit him in stride, he might have had a chance to throw it out there. But, hey, credit Acton Boxborough here. Strung it right out and took down Steven, and it's going to be fourth, and this is probably a kick situation here. You know, we talked about this, Andy, off camera a second. These are the times when you have a 34-35-member team that Reading does that's going to be very difficult to get everybody in. Look for Fleming to boot this one. Lucas does kick it. It's a beauty. Nice kick. Up, takes an actual Acton Boxborough bounce there, though. Wow, get on that ball. Touch it, boys. Okay, don't let it go back there. I mean, that was a very fortunate bounce for
Acton Boxborough,
and that was a nice kick by Lucas. Started rolling, and I think the Reading guys thought it was on their side. Just pouncing that ball, I might have saved 5 yards.
I think that's Steven's rustiness from being out 3 weeks.
Yeah, that'll happen too. You know, we haven't been in the game situations here, but it's going to be first and 10 with very, very good field position for Acton Boxborough, and these guys are going to have to, you know, now that they've seen that first dose of them, we're going to have to ask Reading to step up here. First and 10, AB. Little number 11 goes in. He's talking to number 48. He looks like he's about a foot taller than him. Look for him to try to sweep it. He hands it right here. Oh, immediately ripped down by number 24, Fleming. And he was upset about that kick not going his way. And Fleming busts through and tears him down for a loss of about four.
He wanted to put them back where that ball originally landed.
So nice job by Lucas there for the pushback. And that's exactly what they're going to need right here, the Rockets, if they want to get themselves back into this game. Now, obviously, it's a close game, but this is a big series defensively for them. It's a pitch out right, number 48. They string him out right there. He cuts back. He's still on his feet. Wow, tough guy to bring down. He finally gets pushed out by Fleming. Looks like Troy Pollock down there too. But I'll tell you, 48's about a foot taller than Pollock too coming in there, and he's a little shifty. So he runs that back for about 10 yards. It's going to be third and six upcoming. Gets a bunch of it back there. So let's see if the Rockets can push back here on third. All right, here we go. It's third and call it six here. Big play here. Love to see a pushback from the Rockets. It's a handoff right up the middle. Gets met. Oh, oh, gets pulled by Danny O'Connor. Oakey does a nice job to hold on to him. Then what's his name? Wraps him up. So great job by Dan in there. He's a big dude. And then Fleming came over and helped him out. So big, big play right there. And it's going to be fourth down. And let's see if they're going to go for it here or they're going to try to boot this thing. So great, great play there. It'd be great to see the Rockets get the ball back here. So big play when it counted by number 54.
Yeah,
huh?
The big boy.
Yeah, he's going at 72 over there. He's going to need some ice, I think, at the end of this game. That kid's huge he's going against.
We got him and Danny Junta. They get the whole rest of the line.
Yeah. Nice kick there. Troy's back. Let's see where this one goes. Troy scoops it up. Troy's shifty. Nice job. So he dives forward to about the 25. So nice kick there, too. But that's a big defensive stop for Reading. They know they can do it now. Maybe they'll give a little bit of confidence. And the thing that really hurt him last time, Andy, was really just the hike snap.
Yes.
It was a little bit high, and that pushed some momentum away from the Rockets. And let's see what they have here for the second series. Okay, it is. I think we might have been recording the whole time there. Good thing we didn't say anything off color there. Here we go. It's first and 10. Harrigan in there right to Fleming. Fleming cuts right, puts his head down. He drives that thing for about 5 hard yards. He's a tough guy. You get him in the backfield, too. I don't care how big that line is. Some little guys out back who don't want to see number 24. So, listen, I'm going to blame you on that camera work there.
Yeah, you might as well.
Good thing I didn't start disparaging the coaching staff or some of the other parents, as I've known to do.
I was going to make fun of that O'Connor kid.
Usually I wait until we're on camera before I start making fun of some of the parents having some fun. But this thing's playing like a playoff game right now, which is awesome. Second and call it a long 3, maybe 4 here for the Rockets. Harrigan hands off to Fleming. Fleming cuts back. Oh. He gets pulled down, but he's very close to the first,
it.
And I think he does. He does have it. So nice job for Lucas. And you'll probably see a steady dose of Lucas if this is the case here. And so a couple of nice runs there against that, you know, never mind their offensive line. Well, the offensive line's the same bunch of kids. They're huge. So in comes Steven Webb. I'd love to see Steven, see if we can get outside. He's got some wheels, and we need those back on the team. All right, here we go. First and 10 here from, let's say, the 35-yard line. Webb is back deep. Beckenhuis right in front of him. It's a pitch out to Steven. He's going to try to get outside, and he does. Number 48 wraps him up, and he dives for it. So Steven gets about maybe 4. Nice job, 48. He's got some wheels there, too. So not too often you're seeing guys who can catch up with Steven. But I'd like to see that again because one shifty move, if he looks for him, there could be a lot of room ahead of him. I see you get past number 48, you get back to little number 11. I'd hate to see – that guy doesn't want to see Webb or Fleming bearing down on him. So nice start here. It's going to be second and call it 6 upcoming. All right, we have Harrigan in the shotgun here. Beckenhuis in front of him. Webb is split right. He's in motion now. It's going to be inside handoff to Steven. He's going to cut out right. Nice block by Conroy. Steven dives forward. He's very close to the first. So Trevor Conroy, I said, well, I missed his name last time. He had a beautiful block to seal it off, and Steven cut up, and he's very close to the first. It's going to be maybe not the greatest spot there, but it's going to be 3rd and 1. All right, here we go, 45-yard line. Look for Fleming to follow Beckenhuis if they're looking for 0.5 yard here.
They'll get about 4 with that play.
There it is. And oh, he gets met immediately, but does turn over, and he's got it. So nice job to meet him in there. Big number 75 came in and met him, but Lucas spun around. He's got the first down. So nice job there for the Rockets. And let's keep our snaps in order, and maybe we can see if we can get ourselves a series here, Andy.
Nice to get a score.
I tell you, one of the things that I wanted to talk about is we actually finished all of our player profiles already. We have 34 players, but only 22 sent them to me. So we're just going to make up some stuff about kids, parents, and coaches alike. But
that'll
for
work.
This one, Harrigan in the shotgun. Webb is here. It's an inside hand up to Steven. Steven cuts up. He drives it for about 6 or 7. So nice job seeing the hole and finding it. A lot of times Steven will have the opportunity to swing it wide if he wants or cut up. He cuts that one up for a quick 6. Call it 2nd and a long 4 here after the nice cutback by Webb. Looks like Pollock in motion is Sagala. And Pollock's going to follow. Nice job by Troy. Still on his feet. Nice job, buddy. 1st down and more. So Troy follows that play. We saw that last week. It was Sagala in motion, and he follows Damari. Not the biggest guys, Damari and Pollock, but they're a little shifty, and he takes that for a 1st down. So nice job there into Acton-Boxborough territory. So excellent field position here with the 1st down.
Yeah, Danny's got to be one of the smaller Damaris in town.
He's the only one possibly potentially smaller is Jill Damari. But I will say this, is if he gets that inevitable Damari growth spurt, look out, because he is a great football player. He's got great instincts, and he had a huge game last week. He was awesome. 1st and 10. Well, they're breaking the huddle in Acton-Boxborough. Is still on the sideline over here, so. Looks like we have Patrick Harrigan, and we have He's counting, make sure he's got the right players, and Damari's back with him. Webb split right, look for him in motion. It's a handoff, it's going to be a pass. He throws, he's got Steven. Will he get this? Steven's got it. Oh, he's still at his feet and dives.
Nice.
Beautiful play, and a great play by number 11 there just to do it, but what a pass. It was floated just a little bit under,
yeah.
And he does make the catch. And I mean, you see Steven, he's a foot taller than number 11. It's a huge play, and if Steven had to make one move and he was in, but he dives forward. Great pass and catch by Harrigan, and we talked about it earlier. How great is it to have Steven Webb back on the team? He changes the whole dimension offensively. And I tell you, I wouldn't want to match him up against number 11. He's just too big and too strong back there. Here's Patrick going to throw again, and he throws it up there, and oh, no, it's over his head. It's intercepted on the goal line. He just overthrows what is looks like Barboza out there and Webb. And then we talked about number 11. He's a little guy, but he's a good athlete, and he comes up, and he catches the ball on the one-yard line here. So a turnover for the Rockets will hurt.
That hurt.
At the very least, they pin them way back deep, and they're going to require a huge push defensively here. Let's see if we can get on them. But I'll tell you, that one hurts on the turnover going with a beautiful drive there. And that one just got away from Patrick and sailed over the receiver's head and right in the number 11's hands here. All right, hey, first and 10 here for Acton Boxborough after the quarterback's the guy who made the it's a cutback, and Lucas is right on him and rips him down. So they look like they're trying to spread things out because they're opening up gaps on that defensive line for Redding. That one cut right back into Lucas's hands, and he rips him down. So it's going to be second and nine here. All right, second and nine here. Cameraman Fatino, we're right up by the snack shack here, and the food is wafting right through the windows here and making right up the middle. He gets met immediately. Damari's in there, stacked up by a bunch of players there, too.
Half the team.
Nice job for Damari to get in there. Oki's in there as well, and then in comes Barboza. So it is a good gain here, but this is a very, very big third down play, and I think we call timeout here for Redding because this is one they need a stop on. All right, very big play here, third and five, call it. Pin back deep, and the Rockets would love to see a stop here. It's a handoff right to the little shifty 42, and he gets wrapped up. He's still on his feet, but he does get pushed back. I think he's in there, yeah. Number 15, Harrigan was in there. 43 comes up with the ball. Dante Barboza, but it looks like it's going to be a fourth down. Is that the half? Wow, these are some of the – maybe it's just another timeout here, but
– that's got to be it.
Wow, this may go down as one of the quickest halves I've ever seen in my life, Andy. Although, you know what? Not a lot of passes in the game, so not a lot of clock stopped. So both teams running the ball hard. I go, that might be one of the quickest halves I've ever seen. So at the half, it's going to be Acton Boxborough 6, Redding nothing. Hey, while we're here at halftime, I wanted to bring up last week we were talking about we had sent out some surveys for the coaches were going to answer for the kids, and the ones who didn't send them back, we just make up stuff about Andy.
Works for me.
Needless to say, Coach Pollock is going to be very surprised to learn some of the things that he was into when he watches this week's film. Hey, Coach Webb, little known fact, he's into speed metal and water chestnuts.
Water chestnuts.
Yeah. He finds great joy in living vicariously through his son's accomplishments. Huh? Am I wrong about that? You know, I introduced Dan to Last Corner Restaurant just this year. He's been living in Redding for, 20 years or whatever. Never heard of it.
And seriously.
His business is right by CVS there up above. He went over to Last Corner Restaurant. I thought he was going to hug and cry. He was so happy. Best fries in town, roast beef. Is
20 years
best?
In Redding, you don't know Last Corner.
I literally, let me pump my own tires here. When I was 17 years old, I illegally played in the Redding Men's Softball League. You have to be 18. And I played for the Last Corner Restaurant. Yeah.
What a better team.
It's great. Paul and Val. Have you ever seen a guy whip out more roast beefs in about 5 minutes than Paul? Perfect.
Heck no.
Every time. He's got like 8 arms back there. So, hey, that's a little fun with Coach Danny Webb, right? Dan's he's the taskmaster on the team. He's the disciplinarian when it comes to the fitness. So
the cardio guru.
Yeah, we called him the little fitness ball of hate last year. Yeah. So this is the first year, though, I think most of the kids are actually outgrowing him. So this could be problematic as he goes on in his coaching career. But, hey, Redding's going to get ready to be here. They got Troy and Patrick passing the ball here. It's going to be Redding is going to get the ball back here at the half. But early on, 6-0, this is a very, very evenly matched team. And it's really the only difference here is maybe a bad snap for Redding that stopped one drive, and then a turnover late, which I credit the Rocket defense. So after they basically saw that first series of big act and box score, they've stopped them the last two times. So we're coming up with a second half kickoff upcoming. All right, here we go. Hey, here's ready for the second half kickoff. The Rockets will get it back. Back deep is Stephen Webb and Dante Barboza. Nice kick. It's going Barboza's way. He fields it cleanly. Stephen tries to get in front of him. Dante follows him. Dante takes it for a nice run back for Dante. Gets it back to about the 45-yard line. So he rips off about a 15-yard comeback. It's going to be great field position here for the Rockets to take over. Very, very quick half here, Andy. And a lot of that probably just had to do with the ground play. It's 10-1 here. We maybe get home for the Patriots game. This game was supposed to start at 12:30. I think we started a little bit early. But great game. And I guess the earlier games, the E, the D, and the C team all won. But I'll tell you, this B team is a bunch of monsters from Acton-Boxborough, and a much tougher game here. And unfortunately, our A team is not going to play today. They have too many injuries, and they don't have enough players to field the team.
That hurts.
Yeah, it does hurt. So here we go here. It's going to be Lucas Fleming, number 24, with Beckin Hughes at fullback. It's a keeper for Lucas behind Sean. Oh, nice job there. You got to hold on to that ball. So he gets he's still on his feet. Oh, he almost had one more time. He gets pushed back. It was a great defensive job by Acton Boxborough there. Lucas didn't want to go down. He had one last guy. He might have had daylight ahead of him if he could beat that last guy.
Yeah, there was nobody ahead of him.
That was the toughest minus 2-yard run I've ever seen in my life. So great job
that
there by Acton Boxborough to string him out. All right, here we go. Same setup. We have Barboza split left, Beckin Hughes, and Fleming. Inside handoff to Dante. Dante cuts right and left, and he gets stacked up at the line. So really no gain there. Dante, look at a little bit of happy feet. If you're going to make a dive for that hole, you should take it. And he tried to last minute string it outside and credit the linebackers for Acton Boxborough a little too quick here. So it's going to be third and long here, and the Rockets need to pull something off. Troy Pollock comes in at QB. Third and 11 here. Troy Pollock in there. Other side goes to coaches imploring Dante. So on that side, it's a keeper for Troy. Troy gets met immediately. Nice job, big number, let's see, 48. We've seen him run the ball well, and he closed on Troy very quickly, and it's fourth down here. And it is close to midfield, but you're probably going to see Fleming come here and boot this one. It's a fourth down here. Fleming and Damari are back. Look for Lucas to take this one and kick it. Lucas does kick it. It's a nice kick here. Number 48 has got some room here. Oh, that's a fumble right there. Get on that ball. Wow. Great job by number 48 to hop on it. Barboza closed on him. So did number 42, Derek Van Horn. And he fumbles the kick and does a nice job just to hold on to it. Might have been a big opportunity for the Rockets there. So nice kick this time by Fleming. Nice job by Barboza to hop on it. And Acton Boxborough is going to take over here first and 10 from just about their own 28-yard line. Here we go, first and 10 here for Acton Boxborough. This Rocket D has been really dealing with some big guys on that line on either side. It's a handoff right up the middle, and he gets met immediately. Nice job right there. I think it was 41 is Sean Beckenhuisen. Nice to see him back. He puts a big lick on him. It's a short gain. I'll call it second and 8 coming. Second and 8 coming here for Acton Boxborough. The skies are brightening out here, Andy. A little sun, maybe. You see they have Fleming moving left and right here. Looking for a gap. It's a handoff, big number 48. Nice job by Fleming and Damari. And on comes Danny Oak to clean him up. So they slow him down. Damari and Fleming slow him down, and Oakie comes in and puts a lick on him. And so nice job. He's a big runner. He's a big, tough guy, but they actually push him back for a yard. You know, we talk about Sean Beckenhuis, right, and Dan Damari, two of the biggest hitters on the team, not the biggest guys. If you've seen their fathers, my gosh, if they get their father's size, I don't know who's bigger, Big Dan or Big Dan, a lot of Dans. Everyone named Dan is Dan. Huge on the team.
Except Webb.
Oh, no. He's going to get you for that one. Oh, why? It's a throw right here. It's a little bit up in the air. Oh, my gosh. He almost comes down with it.
Wow.
Wow. He hit it around a little bit. It's the first time we've seen an actual throw, and it was a little bit of air under it. A couple of guys from Reading could have come in and done something. But it's going to be fourth down here and look for them to kick. So great job by the defense right here. Right? Yeah, think about all the Dans, right? Damari, Dad, huge, right?
Yeah.
Dan Beckin, huge. Dan O'Connor, Dan Junta, and then Coach Dan Webb. Nah, I told him we
he's
were going to give
him speed,
something.
He's got his
speed, though. Been very kind to him this year so far. Nice kick right there. Troy's back. Why, right at midfield. Nice job for Troy just to take off. Oh, he's still on his feet, and Troy takes it for a huge run back. So
nice.
Great job by number 7 right there. Good athlete. You know what I like the instincts there, Andy? Take it and run.
Just go
as fast
it.
As you can. Don't get cute. He took it around the end, and he ripped off about 20 yards there. So it's going to be absolutely awesome field position for the Rockets here. And let's see if we can put together a sustained drive here. All you need is 35 yards here, 34 yards, and let's see if we can get on the board. All right, first and 10 here for the Rockets. We got Fleming following Beckenhuis. Oh, tell you, nice play by number 48 to clip him, then get wrapped up by number 42. But Lucas takes it for about 3, maybe 4, and then we switch up the entire offense. These are the types of things that a team with 33, 34 players you have to deal with is just doing minimum plays in a tight game like this is very, very difficult to manage, and no one's done it better than Coach Junter and his coaching staff this year. Right now it looks like Damari in the backfield with Pollock. We've seen this one, his Seagal in here. It's going to be Pollock keeping it behind Damari. Troy's still on his feet, and so he takes that thing very close. He's probably going to be, that was only second down. I think it's third down now. He had the 3 up there, but I think it's 3rd and about maybe 2.
Yeah, 2. Mm-hmm.
So nice play by Troy there, and call it 3rd and short. Okay, big 3rd down play here, but you know it's going to be 4 down territory here. In motion is Webb, and it's going to be following Webb, and it's Troy following Danny Damari, and he's got the 1st and more. All right, don't get cute here. They're going to try to rip the ball down, but he takes the 1st down. So nice job by Troy. Great instincts, right? Follow your blockers. Follow Webb, follow
all
Damari.
All the way.
And to follow it right to a 1st down. So great job there by Troy. We got a new set of 4 here for the Rockets.
Big
and it's very
down.
Close to the red zone here, 20-yard line. Okay, we have Troy Pollock under center for this one. He's got Damari behind him and Webb. It's a handoff to Damari following Webb. Danny's got a little room on the outside. He cuts up. Oh, nice job tackling him below there because he had some room ahead of him. Could have taken it for the 1st, so good tackle. But he takes it for about 6 or 7 on 1st down. And Danny looked like he might have been able to break that one. So I tell you, nice series of runs right here after Acton Boxwell did a great job to start off the half for a quick 3 and out. The Rockets are moving the ball well right here. Okay, we're right back into 2nd and call it a long 4 here. Pollock back under center, Webb back deep. It's a handoff to Steven. Steven cuts it up. He's still on his feet, drives forward. He's got the 1st down, and he almost busted through for the touchdown. So big Steven Webb goes in there. And let's see if we can stay with a steady dose of this run. It's been working on this one, Andy. Let's keep it going here.
So right? We need to just beat it down there.
1st and goal here right now, and the Rockets are threatening. So let's keep it to the big guys. So let's we get number 24 back in there, Fleming. Look for Fleming to follow Beckenhuis. He does handle it. Lucas cuts up. He drives in. I think he's in.
He's up,
Lucas
he's in.
Is
there
in.
There we go.
Beautiful play by Lucas. And, hey, that's the play calling you need right down the end zone. Hold on to the ball. The Rockets tie it up. And look for the Rockets to go for 1 here. They only need 1. And so you may see another steady dose of Fleming right up the middle.
Yep.
Or you could see a sweep here by Steven Webb. But this point is huge. Very, very big extra point here. And look for Fleming again. It's a handoff up the middle of Lucas. He cuts back, and he dives forward, and he's in.
Nice.
Beautiful
nice.
Play by
Needed
Lucas.
That.
And he gets in there, and the Rockets take the lead here. What a game. This has been awesome. It's been playoff football, hasn't it, Andy?
Oh, it certainly has.
We've seen a lot of good teams, you know, this year. 5-1 Acton Boxborough. Drake, it was very good. Wakefield was very good.
Yeah.
So these guys are that's a beautiful sustained drive there by the Rockets. And nice play calling, and more importantly, nice execution with big plays by Damari Webb and the final two going back-to-back with Fleming, and he's a tough guy to bring down. And I don't know, you know, I'd love to find out what the timing is in the game here, because the first half went so quickly. This, we have to listen down here under our headphones to see what the timing is, but it looks like we may be approaching the fourth quarter with the Rockets 7, Acton Boxborough 6. All right, we'll see if we can listen to see what the clock is. Still says third quarter here. Fleming's ready to kick off. These guys are back deep because Lucas can't boot it. Oh, it's a squib kick here. That's a live ball. Ooh, does a good job. I don't know if he meant to squib that or he just hit it off the side of his foot. But the downside of that is Acton Boxborough is going to take over at midfield for the first down here. And I'm not sure if that was on purpose. But unfortunately, there was no real bounce there. It just went sideways. Really weird.
Yeah.
Really weird the way the ball just went there. It rolled like you're rolling it down a hill. And the Rockets defense is going to be asked to do something here. And I'll tell you, they have played very well since the very first series against a big, big, tough Acton Boxborough team. Here we go. Coach Damari imploring Oki and Steven to clear up that end, make something happen here. It's a pitch out to the big number 48. He's got room, and he gets wrapped up immediately. Nice job, and there's a flag, too, so it looks like it might be coming back. But Danny Damari comes in half a foot short of the number 48 and takes him out. So nice job, and it's a hold as well. Let's push him back another 10. And we're going to probably, I don't know if we're going to replay first down and take it. It might be first and 20. I think they're going to take it. And there we are. So we're going to come back first and 20 upcoming. All right, here we go. First and 20 now. Fleming and Oki pounding each other on the shoulders before this, getting pumped up. I tell you, few guys shoot that gap like Danny Damari, too, on the linebacker position. He'll take on anybody. Oh, jumps off. Nice job. Oh, they're going to say he hit someone, and they're going to move him back. Another 5. Unfortunately, Lucas did get back, but he might have touched the other player, which caused him to move. So now it's going to be first and 15. A couple of penalties in a row here. These are the types of things that can really slow the tempo of a game there.
Yeah.
Getting a little too pumped up on that one. He's trying to shoot a gap. He's lining himself up in between guys to get in the backfield.
He was trying to pull a Jamie Collins and get in there before the...
That's right. He'll come right over the top. It's a handoff to number 42. Oh, and there he
is!
On the ground! Oh, boy! He came through and crushed number 42, and wow, fortunate for Acton Boxborough, number 75, to pounce on it. That could have been a turnover that really hurt.
Well, he timed that one.
Wow, we just talked about it, and Fleming mad at himself, and he pushes him back 5 immediately. So instead of first and 20, he makes it second and 20 all by himself. Strips the ball, I'll tell you. The Rockets have been snake bit when it comes to catching some of those fumbles. I said, well, the ball hits the ground, they have to have about an 80% either loss or the other guys get it. That thing was in the air with a couple of Rockets right in the way, and that could have been a dagger. Late here in the third. It's now second and call it 18. Handoff right here. Big hole right there. Nice job by Dante
right
to close it up.
He's spinning him.
He's spun him ahead for about 3 or 4 more yards, doing a little dance with him out there, right?
So, looked like a tango.
Yeah, he looked like he was on Dancing with the Stars right there, Dante. But, hey, he does pull him down. It's third and long here. Huge play here for the Rockets. So the Rocket D has been really something here since that first series. And they're going to be called on for a big play here. You may see them put the ball in the air here again. They haven't had much success since then. So a little number 11 comes out with his play. Okay, very big third down play here. And this is the start of the fourth quarter. So let's see if they put the ball in the air here. We're third and about 13 to go. And they do. They look like they're going to throw. It's a lefty. He throws up underneath, and he makes the catch, but he's down. So he had to go down to make the catch. It was a nice-looking play, but he kneels down. He's going to be short, probably 4th and 6 or 7 from the 50. And this is a very, very tough call here for these guys. You know, it would be excellent field position for the Rockets if they stopped them, but they may just want to boot this one away. All right, it's going to be 4th down here. They do have a guy back to kick. Let's see if he keeps it, though. He hikes it. Let's get a big push here. Oh, he's going to try to throw it. He throws it. Oh, he throws it up the air. Just knock it down. Just knock it down. Nice job. Nice job by Jeremy Ross. That's
Ross.
Exactly what you want to do. No sense even going after it. He tried the trick play. We said look for it. He threw it up. It got a little bit too much air under it. And Jeremy Ross comes in and slaps the thing down, and the Rockets are going to take over on downs with excellent field position. Actually, the same field position that Acton Boxborough started with. And so let's see if Redding can do something here with a one-point lead here at the beginning of the fourth. What a great play by Ross. And I think that ball might have got a little bit too much air for those guys. There are a lot of Rockets there defending it. And it's going to be first and 10 here. It looks like we have Damari and Troy Pollock. They go into Pollock and Damari a lot in the second half here. Two guys have been very effective for them. And there's Damari. Up, Danny gets pulled down immediately by number 48. So nice job there. And it's going to be second and 10 from midfield. And there now we have Matt Sagala in the fullback role. Pollock into center. It's a handoff to Lucas. Lucas cuts right. He's still on his feet. Oh, nice cutback. Oh, he's still on his feet. He spins for the first down. Wow. The big man, you see number 43, Dante Barboza, giving the first down. And that's a huge run there for Fleming. And I'll tell you, usually you don't see too much shiftiness out of Lucas. But he did a spinorama there and got the first down. So huge play for the Rockets. And it's going to be first and 10 from the Acton Boxborough 40. Rockets come right back out. They don't want this defense to rest. Look for a steady dose of the run right here. Take some time off the clock. And Lucas is the guy you want to do it with. He takes it right. He gets met immediately. Spins this time. He's still, oh
another
boy.
4 yards.
He drives it for maybe four or more. I say seven.
Yeah.
Wow, number 48 came in. He's a good player too, and he met him. Lucas spins around again and drags him and two other guys for another few yards. It's going to be second and three. So now we see Stephen Webb, some speed coming in. Give Lucas a breather on this one. They are imploring the O-line to push their coaches. Stephen Webb back deep. It's a pitch out to Webb. He cuts up. Stephen, nice job. Dives forward. He's got the first. So nice job for Stephen. Good cutback from Stephen. I'll tell you, he hasn't played in 3 weeks. He looks like he's been practicing in his backyard. But we were just saying, your son, Andrew, unfortunately, out with concussion protocol, and they did the same thing with Stephen Webb earlier. And we had a couple of other guys out, too. They're not messing around anymore, Andy, when it comes to taking care of the kids' health here.
No, they get the symptoms. They get that word concussion.
Oh, they didn't give him the first down, but it's third and inches here. Damari here. Hand off to Dan. Dan takes it forward.
He's got it.
Definitely got it there. There's no doubt about it. So first down for the Rockets. And all that does is take some more time off the clock here. So so the third and short actually probably didn't hurt the Rockets there. We get the first down, and it's going to be first down from inside the 30.
Huddle.
I know. Hey, listen, credit the Rockets. They are busting out of that huddle quick. They don't want to let this big defensive line rest. And they are just rolling guys in there. It's a pitch out to Webb now. He cuts up. Steven puts his head down. They're going to call maybe a hold here, unfortunately, on the Rockets. Yeah, it is a hold, but Steven made a nice dive there for about six or seven, but they're going to bring it back and make it first and 20. Unfortunate penalty right there for the Rockets. They're moving the ball very well. All right, here we go. It's going to be first and 20 here for the Rockets. And I don't know how much time is left here in the fourth, but we're probably halfway through the way these things are running. There's Beck in Houston motion. Haven't seen that one, but it's going to be a follow with Troy follows Stephen. Oh, nice job. He almost strips the ball out of there. Troy's still on his feet. He's still on his feet.
Oh, my God.
Wow. Tell you what a play by Troy Pollock. He refuses to go down, and he's not the biggest. He's probably our smallest back out there, Troy, and he just refused to go down there, and he takes it for a few yards. Let's call it, he might have taken that for just a couple, only two, but one of the toughest two-yard runs you'll ever see.
It's a hard fight.
It's going to be second and 18 here for the Rockets. The play. Coach is imploring the offensive line to give a big push here. Get Adam Diemer in there, Andrew Hattery, Danny Junta. In motion. It's a keeper right. It's a pitch out to Steven. Nice athletic play to get him. And I'll tell you, a good tackle there. And the only reason that was even allowed is that Steven had to go down to get it. That was actually a great play by Steven just to hold on to that ball. So the athleticism there could have turned into a really, really terrible play there for the Rockets. And, hey, credit number, I forget who came in on the outside. It looks like number 34 or 32 came in and pushed him back. So it's going to be third and forever here. But you know what? You may very well see fourth down territory here. If they can take some time off the clock, you know, they'd love to see a play here, put some you may see them stay with the run here this late in the game.
Burn the clock out.
Try to burn that clock out. But Troy is going to throw it. Oh, nice play by Troy there just to pull it under. He's still on his feet. Oh, he cuts back, and Troy makes something out of nothing. And he gets here. That's good field position right there. He kicks it to the maybe 35-yard line. So now you might see themselves try to pin them deep, way deep here. I give them the ball at the very end here. We don't know how much time is left, but you may also see them just hold on to the ball because that's still good field position. You know, so we'll see what Coach Junta does here on fourth down. You're only getting a net gain of 15 yards, but 15 yards here late in the game, the way the defense – the good news is the defense has been able to rest right now.
Yeah, they're playing good right now.
They're playing very, very well. So it looks like a timeout Reading, and we'll come back. They're going to rethink this fourth down play. They just named free hot chocolate up here in the snack shack. They're making a rush on the thing like it's they're gonna knock over the footings here. This whole thing may come out. It's a fourth down play, and Troy's gonna throw this thing. He rolls out, he throws it up, and Steven's he actually had Webb open, and he just led him too far. If he put it out to Steven, there was all sorts of room ahead of him. So actually, a very well set up play. Let Troy roll out. That's what we talked about with Troy was gonna throw because he's a smaller guy. Let him roll out and throw it. So they're just going to turn the ball over here on downs. He just led Steven too much there. And even Steven, if he did catch it, he would have been short because he would have been down there. But if he hit him in stride, my gosh, what a play. That was a beautifully set up play and just throwing a little bit out of Steven's reach here. And now we're going to be asking this D to do it one more time here. And this is crunch time here with how much time. We'll see if we can listen down on the field how much time is left. But you know, these guys, it looks like there's not a lot of pass plays in this Acton-Boxborough regimen here. So look for a lot of runs here. Look for big number 48 right here. It's a keeper right, 48. He gets closed almost immediately. What a play. Danny Damari. Wow, coming in from the defense. We talked about
and
how
Steven
he closes.
On the other side.
Steven Webb on the other side, and they put a crunch on him. And absolutely nowhere to go right there. Damari came in untouched. And I'll tell you, what a football player that guy is.
He might be small, but he is, man.
Oh, he is good, man. No one hits the hole like him. And what a player on both sides of the ball, too. Danny, huge pushback, and they needed it. And that run is going to just take more and more time off the clock here. Precious seconds with the Rockets holding on to a one-point lead. What a great football game this has been. Back deep in the shotgun. They look like they're going to mix in some passes here. He keeps it himself. Oh, he gets immediately crunched.
Swallowed.
Steven Webb on the left and Oki on the right. Wow, they keep pushing him back. So this D's getting even more fired up, and they don't have an answer for Webb on the outside right now. And then Oki helps him out. Steven grabs him from behind, and Oki crunches him the other side. So I'll tell you, what the play of the defense right here for the Rockets has been outstanding. So clearly we might be looking at four down territory here, but they are just going in the wrong direction. It's third and 20. Not a lot of plays in the book for that, Andy.
No, they really aren't.
So let's see. They might try to put the ball up in the air. You got Pollock and Barboza back deep, and they're probably going to tell them, knock this
ball.
Thing down.
Yep.
Knock it down, right? You don't have to be a hero here. It's a high snap. He's going to throw it. He throws a great pass, and there's Troy. Troy almost intercepts the ball. Nice play. Number 48 was out there. Patrick Harrigan had tight coverage on him, too. But that was a beautiful pass, huh? Number 14, nice little spiral there, and that was right at the first down marker. And Troy almost comes down with it. Now, this is a fourth down play. It's timeout Acton-Boxborough. They have to rethink this one. But this play could very well mean the game here. So coming back quickly. This is the play that will probably determine this game. It's late, at least halfway through the fourth here, and it is fourth and forever. Call it 21 or 22. They're going to tell Pollock, they're going to tell Damari, and they're going to tell Barboza, stick with your guys, and let's see if these big guys, the Webbs and Richmonds, and these guys can get a push on these guys. because it looks like it's definitely a pass play. Oh, and there's the flag. Too many guys on. They're going to push him back another five. Oh, that's a killer there. Too many guys on. And they had to take a delay of game penalty. Now it's going to be fourth and a mile.
Fourth and forever.
I'm sure you called the same exact play, adding just an extra five there. But this is a long, this is a tough call here for in motion number 10. Sean Stasem. It's going to be a double pass here. Look for this thing. Oh, he's right there. Troy's there. Oh, nice job by Troy. How smart is that play? He could have went up and taken it. He just knocks it down. He was coached perfectly on that play. Knocked the ball down, and we're going to take over with unbelievable field position. So they tried the old double pass. Good-looking throws there, but the Rocket defense, ever since the beginning of that first series, has been awesome this game. I don't know how much time we got left, but they have excellent field position. Let's look for a steady dose of the run here. Fleming, Damari, Pollock, keep the ball on the ground and run this thing out. We could put a stamp on it with a score here.
The score would be big.
All right, here we are, first and 10 from just outside the 20-yard line. And we have Lucas back deep. Look for him to follow Sagala. That's exactly what he does. Lucas, oh, beautiful tackle. Nice tackle by number 48. Comes in and wraps him up beautifully for probably a no gain, but beautiful form tackle right there from 48. And I tell you, he's a very good player on this team on both sides of the ball, but they need a couple more 48s, I think, against Reading. But this game has been really great. And the last thing Reading wants to do, they want to hold on to that ball. No turnovers. Let's be calm with it. Let's run this clock down. Second and 10 right here. I'll tell you, this game looks very similar to the Drakett game where we went for two early and missed it. We lose 7-6, and that's precisely what Acton Boxford did. Look for Damari here. Oh, it's going to be a keeper for Troy. He goes outside. Nice job there. Nice tackle. Beautiful tackle, number 34 on the other side. So
he read that
listen,
play.
He just did a nice job closing on it. Troy had one guy to beat. It was actually a pretty nice call. He got around the end on the keeper. But 34 comes in and closes the door and pushes them back. So great defensive stand here. And they might have called timeout to stop this clock. So good job here. It's third and 14 coming up. And the Rockets would love to just get some yardage here. I wouldn't suspect the Rockets to put this one in the air this late. But it's also four down territory. So you got to think of it that way. Two more runs for 12 yards. That's the way you'll see Coach Junta probably go this route. All right, here we go. Lucas Fleming back deep. Look for Lucas here. It is a handoff to Lucas. He's on his feet. Cut back. Nice job. And Lucas drives that thing for about maybe 8 or 9. So now it's going to be 4th and 5. It's definite 4-down territory here. You got him deep.
All means.
So this is a huge play for the Rockets here. If they pull off a first down, that might be all she wrote. But I tell you, big, huge defensive play for Acton Boxborough. They need to get the ball back here and quick. And here it is. No secrets here, right? Look for number 24 to get it. Looking for a big push here. It's a handoff to Lucas, and Lucas, oh, he just slips. Too bad there, because all he needed to do is get to the thing, and he just slips on the grass there, and they're going to turn the ball over. He had some room ahead of him, too. So, tell you, unfortunate slip for Lucas. They turn the ball over on downs, and we don't know how much time is left on the clock. We'll see if we can listen. But Acton Boxford is going to get the ball back here deep in their own territory. And we're going to be asking that Rocket defense to do something here again. Way, way too close here. And if there's a trick in their bag, they're going to try to pull it out here. All right. They might try to put the ball in the air here, too, because they need to keep that clock going. He looks underneath, and he's got room there. Nice job there. And Barboza pushes him out, so a nice little gain probably gets him to maybe a gain of 5 there. So 2nd and 5, they do get out of bounds and stop the clock. Fleming imploring his team to get fired up here. He's right over the middle, 24. Need a big push here. Like to see one of these guys get in the backfield again. Oh, right there, Webb runs into his own guy. Oh, Keith Richmond, nice job by Richmond. And Oki comes in to pile on. right?
Put him
nice
down.
Nice job by Richmond. And you know what happened is Webb came in so quick, he actually ran into Lucas. He was in untouched. He could have hit him way back. Now they're in a hurry-up offense here. I think they might be running out of time here. Oh, and he spikes the ball, so that's exactly what they do. While Lucas even gets to him on the spike. So they stop the clock, but it's fourth down here. So fourth and 10, this is going to be the game here for the Rockets. Look for these guys to probably pass the ball. It looks like they got some guys who throw some nice spirals there.
That they do.
A nice set of plays, but they don't have time here. He's imploring them to get out there. It's fourth and 12 here, and this will be the game, I believe. It's so late in the game that they need this first down to keep the chains going. And here we go. See if the Rocket defense can do it one more time.
They got a lot of guys wide.
They sure do. They got a lot of guys back deep to try to keep it within here. And he got pressure on him. He throws it up. And Jeremy Rosh does it again, and he knocks it down. Playing a little patty cake there. He could have taken that thing if he wanted to. No need to. Knock it down. Smart play. Smart coaching. The Rockets are going to take over here, and I think it's got to be getting too late here. They were trying to stop that clock. I think all the Rockets may have to do is kneel on this one. And that, they're switching out the offense here. Everyone's fired up, and that Rocket defense, what a great game, huh? Hey, Andy, you're bringing it. You brought it today, my friend.
That's what I'm here for.
Yeah, yeah. The commentary, the color commentary that you've added here was enlightening. It was smart. It was really something.
Yeah, I should have left baseball years ago.
I know. Former commissioner of Reading Youth Reading Little League. Don't say Reading Youth Baseball anymore.
Yeah, don't curse me.
There it is. You brought Little League to Reading. You know what's going to happen, Andy? This is what's going to happen. When one of our boys goes to Williamsport and we win this thing, they're going to say, I remember the guy that did it. And that's it for the Rockets. What a game. Absolutely awesome. And it looks very, like I said, very similar to that Drakett game. Active Boxborough goes for two early. They march right down on the very first series. And the Rockets, I tell you, this was a game for the Rockets defense after that first series. They were getting punched in the mouth that first series, and they took it personally. They took it personally, and they shut the door later in the game. Hey, credit Coach Bob Junta, too. How do you deal with 33 guys getting them on that team? And this was a very big, one of the biggest teams I've seen. This active
size-wise,
team.
Yeah, they were huge.
And what's great about this is that we might run into all these guys in the playoffs. Hey, good for us. Actually, next week, we are off next week because Wilmington does not have a B team. And you know what? I bet you the coaching staff is saying, fine with us. Let's get 2 weeks. Let's get everybody back healthy again. Steven Webb's return was a huge bonus for the Rockets. And great plays all around. You know, some names you want to throw out there. Damari, of course. Fleming, awesome. Having Webb back. And then that big defensive line. Fleming, Oki, Junta, Steven Webb, Richmond. Those guys were awesome all day. And it was also great to have Sean Beckenhuis back. And he made a lot of big plays. So this team looks very, very different when all the guns are back, right?
Oh, but, definitely.
Hey, Andy, thanks so much for joining me this week.
I appreciate it.
Maybe your son will get back here in 2 weeks. And
let's hope so.
Yeah, we have 2 weeks to get your boy healthy. And then maybe we'll fire Brian Van Horn.
There we go.
We'll bring you right back. Oh, should we call him, oh, my bad back, Van Horn?
I can't say.
All right, hey, guys, we will be back in 2 weeks, and it's playoff time for the Rockets then. But what a great game here in Acton-Boxborough. Very, very evenly matched game. Very tough team, and the Rockets are pumped up with this 7-6 victory. Awesome. We'll see you next week.